the Brody house is endangered, and that's the best and biggest Quincy Jones house in LA, and it has to be saved.
Hollywood is built on the pioneering of modern architecture, revival architecture, and it's quickly disappearing. And so we are alarmed at the rate it's going away, and so we're here to do something about it.
Being a native and being up and seeing our iconic properties being torn down, that's where we come in.
Our goal is to educate the public about the iconic structures in their neighborhood and preserving them.
The architects were pioneers of their time and of their generation. Don't destroy what was. Well, we're tooling through Truesdale Estate.
This is a special enclave of houses. There's not that many of them. They're very rare. It's like watching an extinct group of animals start to be poached.
Oh my gosh, this looks like it needs help. Yeah, but you know, with some help and our magic.
Oh yeah. Mm. When it comes to architecture and collecting art, a lot of people don't see it as a parallel, but for me, we do. And architecture is such a thought-provoking piece of art in the third dimension instead of the second dimension. If we can bring awareness to the wonderful structures that are iconic and worth collecting, I think it would be wonderful for the world to see it.
I'm passionate about those iconic structures that are so one of a kind that you'll never ever experience that type of architecture ever again. The Chasins Estate was designed by noted architect Paul Williams, who also designed Chasins Restaurant, where Hollywood mixed it up, where scripts were sold, where affairs were found out. The Chasins Estate was the only mid-century property that Paul Williams ever designed, and I had the rare opportunity of spending many, many hours there with friends who owned it. The new owners promised our friends that they would save the house and wouldn't do anything to it. And it literally was 2 weeks later, they demolished the house to put in a McMansion. It was an architectural crime.
We're seeing on the market some noteworthy properties that are exquisite and not landmarked in any way, and they're in the crosshairs.
It's really hard to narrow down which one we're going to preserve first.
Here's Owlwood, which Tony Curtis lived there.
So we came up with a criteria based on who the architect was.
The DeMille house is a different story.
One of our favorite houses.
The cultural relevance. Who lived there? What happened in the house?
A Gordon Kaufmann residence, the architect of the Greystone Mansion.
Built for Ed Doheny of There Will Be Blood fame.
And the artfulness and uniqueness of the property.
Okay, it's Cecil B. DeMille, for God's sake. That's
it. What else do you have to say?
I think we're done.
All it takes is just one person. Either way, whether you choose to demolish something special or you choose to actually save it. Unfortunately today, the way of the world, most people don't know what they don't know. We are driven to save iconic architecture across this nation.
If we don't save them now, they're gone forever. Help us save iconic architecture.
Beside the garden wall, when stars are bright, you are in my arms. The nightingale tells his fairy tale, a paradise where roses bloom. Though I dream in vain, in my heart it will remain my stardust melody, the memory of love's refrain.